We are one day away from this historic boxing event. The last time an undisputed boxing champion was crowned was 25 years ago.
And the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Lennox Lewis.
Since then, we've had 6 different Olympic Games, 6 FIFA World Cups, 6 Rugby World Cups, and 25 Super Bowls. Now joining me from across the country, my friend Seth Speaks from New Hampshire. Hello, Seth, you there?
How you doing, buddy?
I'm
good, thank you. I think Fury's going to win it. If he's going to knock him out, it's going to be between the 8th and the 10th round, but I think it's going to go to points just based on the height, the reach advantage. He's lost 20 pounds. I mean, I know he struggled against southpaws traditionally, but he's actually originally, I don't know if anybody knows this, he's originally a left-handed southpaw boxer, but he was taught orthodox.
Yes.
The only thing is with Usyk is, I mean, they both have ring IQ. They're both feisty. But because he's shorter, he's still strong. He's going to use, you know, his good defensive mastery that he has because, I mean, he's had the title since 2021. And he's not going to want to just give that up that quick. So I think it's going to be a good fight. But I also think Fury's going to win.
Tyson Fury weighed in at 262 pounds, while Usyk weighed in at 223.5 pounds. Tyson Fury almost 30 pounds heavier, 6 inches taller, and a 7-inch reach advantage. In order for this fight to happen, all the stars had to align. Both fighters had to capture all the main titles in the heavyweight division. They also had to come to an agreement when it came to negotiating how much money they were both going to be paid. Allegedly, Tyson Fury will walk away with $150 million and Alexander Usyk will pocket $30 million. I don't know if there's going to be a rematch clause, but I'm guessing there is probably going to be one because these fighters are both undefeated and they stand head and shoulders above everybody else in the heavyweight division. And then you have a guy like Alexander Usyk who stays in shape in and out of the ring. He's always mentally strong, physically tough. And coming into the fight, you know he's going to be firing in all cylinders.
Well, Dave, can I say something?
Yes.
I think that's the difference between the Eastern European and the Western European fighters is Eastern Europeans, they traditionally take care, even in soccer, they take, you know, better care of themselves. The Western Europeans, they tend to, they want to let it go, but they're also bigger people. I mean, you want to talk about, you have 7 inches of reach and 50 pounds on them. I mean, that's a lot. So, when it's all said and done, I still think it's going to be a good fight just because Usyk is just a feisty character. If he's going to knock him out, it's going to be in between 8 to 10. If he were 300 pounds and you go 12 rounds, I mean, imagine what you can do at 275. Well, the thing with Usyk, too, is he's, I mean, first of all, he's had the title for a couple years, like I said, but like you were saying, he could just adapt on the fly. I mean, he's good defensively, but it's just tough to overrule someone with such a height and a weight advantage who's skilled. But paper isn't always right, you know. You heard it here first. Who's second eight? So to me, I still think Fury's gonna win, but Usyk has a chance just because. I'll tell you this, some people show their weaknesses out front. So, I don't know if you saw it, he displayed himself as a southpaw. But if you look at his fights against southpaws, he's prone to get knocked down.
I have Alexander Usyk taking this fight. I think he's going to finish him within 8 rounds. He's going to come into this fight and fight methodically. He's going to collect all the data he needs early. He's going to set a lot of traps. Fury has struggled in his last fight against Ngannou. And in Fury's last 5 fights, I believe he's been dropped 4 times. And that's one of the things that never gets stronger in your career. And that's you seeing guys like Chuck Liddell, you're seeing guys like Roy Jones, you know, all the greats. And, you know, every fighter is different. Some fighters stay in shape and stay in their prime longer. And I believe Tyson hasn't taken care of his body the way he needs to and the way he should to become a champion for long term.
When it comes to footwork, he's a lot faster and smoother, a lot slicker with his skill set. I think that he also has better defense, head movement, and can hit you in different angles. Usyk's one of those fighters that gets stronger as the round goes, and he's also very durable. He can adjust during the fight, and that's another reason why he's undefeated.
Eight, I think he's gonna work the body and then chop him down and then finally knock him out.